Oh, Tyler, 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 Tyler. Why do you continue to make films like this?
Somebody got into my account. They got my passwords. Somebody has stolen my identity. I can't believe you do this to me. I can go to jail.
I'm your husband. You know the laws of this state.
Hey everybody, welcome back to About the Popcorn. Thank you for clicking on this video. If you guys are new, my name is Stephanie. Today we're going to be talking about Netflix's newest film, A Fall from Grace. Fall from Grace was released on Netflix January the 17th. It is directed, screenplay, produced by Tyler Perry, and as the production studio, also Tyler Perry Studios. So this review is going to be spoilers. It's going to be my first 2020 spoiler review. Because quite honestly, you really shouldn't watch this movie, you guys. So starting off the bat, Tyler Perry has been in the game for many, many, many years, you guys. Why does he insist on giving us things like this? Like, this is stuff that you do when you are starting off in the game. Like, not when you're this much in it already. Like, I mean, well, the movie is what you expect from a Tyler Perry movie, you guys. Because let's face it, Tyler Perry doesn't make the best films. Like, you try to give it the benefit of the doubt, but at the end, it always kind of falls short, and it's always, like, the same thing. And honestly, I really wish that, well, one, that he would get writers for this. I'm assuming it's just him writing it, and he really should get other people to help. Like, honestly, like, I get it that you want to write your own things because you want to put your own stuff out there. Okay, I get it. I mean, Tyler, really, I love you, sweetie, I do, but you are not the best writer. You're really not. And I really wish that he would stop doing, like, this same concept of film. Like, you're supposed to be giving more opportunities, better roles to women of color, and you're doing the same shit. A black woman who is broken, who is bitter, who is angry, who's lonely. Like, a lot of these stuff can be relatable to a lot of people. It's stereotypical and putting people in certain roles, but yet you're writing said role. And because it's him writing them, you know, it's more acceptable. Well, let me leave Tyler alone. Let me get to the actual movie. That's what you're here for, right? Is to hear about my thoughts about the movie. Okay, so A Fall from Grace is basically like a soap opera and like a Lifetime movie put together. When you watch the movie, you get Tyler's sense in here. Like, I mean, all his movies have about the same tone. They have the same feeling. They have that overplaying of the score behind that comes up a little bit too high for me. I'm just like, that's literally what you would hear more in those Lifetime movies. Sometimes literally the score would like overpower what the people were saying, and it's just like it was very distracting. I mean, I get that you're trying to have like this dramatic like feel, but like you don't need to put that value out, you know, just lower it back down, you know. And the lawyer, quite honestly, I disliked her from the beginning because I was just like, so you're really not gonna try to help this client out regardless if they are trying to do a plea bargain. The latter part of the movie is where she finally started to kind of care, but like throughout the thing she's just like, no, I don't want none of this, and I'm just like so unlikable. The characters, oh you guys, like it was nothing good about this. And then okay, one thing before I forget, I am not an expert on this at all, but those wigs were terrible, right? Like this video if you agree that those wigs were terrible. I'm Tyler, like I know you could do better than that. Like, how could you put both these women and men in these terrible wigs? Like, just spend all your money in your studio that you couldn't get some good wigs. I give you the plot twist on this, because again, you should not even see this movie. So if you are actually looking forward to seeing this movie, you can go ahead and click off here. If you don't mind spoilers, continue to watch. Yeah, everything was a con, so you pretty much, I think, caught that on from the trailers that he was a con artist. The twist is that the best friend, the one that basically kind of worked her into going to this art show to meet the guy, is up being the mama. So they are actually a mom and son con artist duo deal, which that I did not see coming. I didn't really say much about the movie, but there's really not much to say about the movie. My favorite part about the movie was possibly just Cicely Tyson. I'm actually happy that it came on Netflix, because I can tell you this, if it came on theaters, I would be like, don't you even dare go waste a single penny for this damn movie. So with that, I'm gonna go ahead and just give it a small popcorn rating, because it's just, it's not, you know what, screw the small popcorn. I'm gonna give it a theater movie cup rating. You know, those free little, you put little tap water in there, that's what this shit is worth. If you wanna watch it, but I'm just pre-warning you, it's not good. People may actually enjoy it. If you saw this movie and you enjoyed it, let me know down below. What did you like about it? Please don't like get mad at me for dissing this movie. It's my own opinion. I was just not here for it. Maybe I'm just not the targeted audience for this. Read some reviews on this and it's not good, you guys. So I'm not alone. But you may be that unicorn that really enjoys and loves this movie. If you haven't seen it, are you looking forward to watching it, or have I changed your mind on it? But before you guys click out of this video, don't forget to give it a like, subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet, and of course, don't forget to hit the notification bell so you'll be notified each time I post something new. And until next time, I'll be seeing you guys at concessions. Bye!